Hey everybody, Jay-Z Crazy here. This is what my meals consist of while I'm getting well. And I'm not feeling well, I like to eat Raisin Bran. I like to have Special K, Chocolatey Delight. And of course, you can't forget about the Hall's Cough Drops. Now, I have no idea what I'm doing with this stuff. I have no idea why I'm telling you these things. But I guess I'd just like to share my life with you. Now, sometimes I mix the cereals together. I've always done that. I could have 5-6 different kinds of cereals. I like to mix them. I'm like Jerry Seinfeld, crazy with the cereal. I've always been like that. I try to eat healthy cereal. Raisin Bran is probably the healthiest we have. I know this has chocolate in it. Lisa can't have chocolate. She has a spoonful of this. She'll be 6 feet under.
Why do you tell these people this about me? I did not.
Because it's true.
I didn't give permission.
They can look back at any of the other videos where I talk about you being allergic to chocolate.
Why are you telling me about that? I didn't say that with you, okay?
Lisa's allergic to chocolate. Stop it!
Oh, I keep these.
So, no, you don't keep those. I need those.
You threw them at me.
Give them to me.
That means they're mine now.
Give them to me. Give them to me. Just hit a square in the head.
And see, I'll keep this too. I won't eat it, but I'll keep it.
Give them to me. I'll hit you on the other side of the head.
What? You try?
Give everything to me. Come on. Everything. Come on. Oh, jeez. Are you okay?
My hand. You're trying to kill me.
Hit her a little harder than I meant to.
This is proof you're trying to kill me.
Great. Now this video proof I've assaulted you. Come lock me up.
Three times.
Come lock me up. As long as I get dental care and I can get this wisdom tooth ripped out of my head, I'll accept being arrested for a little while.
Oh, they'll pull your tooth out for free.
Why can't it be like, give me that? Why can't it be like the Three Stooges where I tie a rope around my tooth?
I knew you were going to say that.
Can you? We'll do that right now.
No, let's
not. That'll be a good Jay-Z crazy video. That'll go viral.
That won't work.
Tie a string around this tooth.
What string? What do you think?
Find a string.
Find a string.
There's got to be a string around here somewhere. And tie it to my tooth, and we'll tie the other end to a doorknob. And we'll try to see if you can pull my tooth out.
It doesn't work.
Don't know until we try.
It's a wisdom tooth. They have to actually have a thing that pulls it.
You're going to pull it.
I'm not pulling anything.
Don't make me throw these at you again.
Listen, I'm not pulling it because there's a reason.
Come on, pull my tooth. Come on.
I don't have Novocaine.
Why can't you do that for me?
I just said I don't have Novocaine or the training to even know.
Forget about the Novocaine. I'll deal with the pain.
No, you won't. You'll be bleeding.
I'm strong.
You'll be bleeding everywhere. It's like getting...
You like blood, so you may actually enjoy that.
No, I don't like blood that way. It's not like I like it. I'm okay with it.
If you're a dentist, would you be against Lisa pulling my tooth out with a string?
Yes.
Is that a bad idea?
That's a bad idea.
Leave your comment below. Has there ever been a situation where that has actually worked out for somebody other than the Three Stooges?
No. Little kids do this to themselves.
Yeah. Oh, so if little kids have done it,
no.
And they're alive, why can't I do it?
They're always missing a permanent tooth, and it's always in front. You're not supposed
to. I'm missing a permanent tooth, too. But mine just didn't grow in for some reason.
What I'm saying is that the molars, you can't do it with them. They have usually three roots that hold in. You need a dentist.
This is really fucking bothering me, people. It's no joke. That's bothering me over there, too. What are you doing? I got two things bothering me. My tooth and... You know.
No.
So anyway.
Yeah, that stuff, I rub it all over the table.
What?
Rub it all over the table. What are you, Mr. Mix? Oh!
Hold on, everybody. Are you okay? No, you're sick.
I was already sick, remember?
Hold on. For the next 2 minutes, this video is going to be completely pointless. More pointless than usual. They're all over the floor now.
You made the mess.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Didn't even realize the bag was open. Thought we had two bags, and I thought the other one was open.
They're all open.
But apparently, yeah, this one was the one that was open.
All of them are open.
What do you recommend for a tooth that's coming in that hurts? Good. Lisa says ice cream can help. I had some ice cream. I don't think that's helping.
Yeah, you should go to the dentist and have them yank it out.
Thanks, Einstein. I know that.
Oh.
Okay. I have to wait until next week now.
A pain pill.
A pain pill? I don't have a pain pill.
Or like half a pain pill.
What kind of drugs do you think I have here?
I mean, like aspirin. Just like a simple baby aspirin.
Aspirin I have. Can you get me an aspirin in the other room? There's a baby aspirin on the nightstand. Don't know why we have baby aspirin. We have no babies.
Those for you.
But could you grab me one anyway? No, do I just place that? Have you been drinking? She's wobbling around the room like either she got struck by an iron in the head or she's had a fifth of vodka.
Neither happened. Unless, oh, that's right, you've been throwing things and hitting me directly in the head.
You know, when I started doing this particular video, I felt like hurrying. Now all of a sudden, I don't give a shit if this goes on for 2 hours. I don't know why, I just don't care. If you don't like long videos, then shut this one off. Because I don't feel like I'm in a hurry to rush out of the room. Now, what do? Do I place this in the back? On the tooth?
No, you just take it like you would normally take it. This is something you can dissolve in your mouth, but it's baby aspirin, so just let it dissolve.
99% chance this won't help me at all.
That's right.
Thank God I have a whole bottle here.
Right, there's Tic Tacs, right?
This looks like the greasiest pizza I've ever seen.
That's why we
from Little Caesars.
Oh, let's not ever get one from there. Thanks. I'm not interested in greasy pizzas.
I have a friend.
Yeah.
Who thinks he's cool.
Yeah, I can't agree with that one.
And he gets the greasiest, cheesiest pizzas
ever
I've ever seen in my life. Cheese is not good for you. It'll clog your arteries. You'll end up having a heart attack and dying.
He seems to think it's...
And some people have pizzas like that 2 or 3 times a week. 4 times a week. Sometimes 5 times a week. Now, if you're eating this consistently, several times a week.
Oh, yeah.
You're not doing your body any favors.
He said he had high cholesterol. I told him that.
It doesn't surprise me he has high cholesterol if he's eating this shit 5 times a week. If you care about yourself, treat your body as a temple.
He doesn't care about himself.
Watch what you put into it.
He doesn't care.
Because if you eat a lot of garbage, your body's going to look like a big pile of garbage.
It's going to look like a dumpster?
Your body's going to look like a dumpster.
Thank you.
Okay. I try to eat healthy. You know, Subway's good. Here's some Subway coupons. At least a nice fresh sub. That's a lot better than a pizza that's overloaded with garbage on it.
That's why you can get your cheap and make sure you get light cheese, lots of veggies.
Ooh, buy a $25 Subway card and get a free 6-inch sub. Free 6-inch sub. If you buy a $25 gift card.
Well, then it's not free, it's actually $25. If you think about it.
I know. But it's good for Christmas if you want to give away a gift card.
Well, yeah.
You buy a $25 gift card and you get a tiny sandwich out of it.
Or...
maybe not the most generous offer, but... yeah, they're trying. You notice how many coupons you get around Christmas time?
They're the same.
Is this just all from today?
Yeah, we always get the same amount all the time.
Seems like a lot more. No, just for one day.
They're the same.
No, it's not. Around Christmas time, they always send a lot more out.
Well, I usually keep them. That's what I'm saying. They're the same.
But these are all from today, though.
I know. They sent the same stuff before that was the holidays.
There's a 19-inch LED TV for only $88 here.
That's insane. You can grade all at the same time.
That's a pretty good deal. But I noticed that a lot of stores, the new TVs have gone way down in price. They're not expensive like they used to be. I remember in the old days... now I sound like somebody's grandfather.
That's why I started laughing.
Back in the old days...
that's why I started laughing.
When we had television issues, we have a TV repairman come out to the house with a toolbox. And then he would pull the big TV away from the wall and take the back off. And then you could see all the tubes and all the wires. And then he would have to diagnose the problem. And that would usually take about half an hour. And then to fix the TV, sometimes it would cost $75, $100.
Yeah, my dad just would fix it himself. My grandfather was the same way.
Of course, I really don't remember all of this. My whole time growing up, I don't think we ever had a TV repairman come out to the house. That's even before my time. My parents may have had that, and my grandparents. But for the price they paid to fix a TV, now you can just go out to the store and buy a brand new one. So why fix it? Plus the new TVs they make these days, I don't think they're quite as easy to fix. You can't just take the back off and replace a tube or a circuit.
But I fixed mine.
Everything's self-encompassing. Everything's soldered on. You can't just replace things easily anymore.
Yeah, no, they're all screwed on. I take the back off of mine all the time to make sure that everything's working okay. So it's not soldered.
Why do you need to take the back off of your television ever?
Well, when the power supply went.
She keeps having issues with her TV.
No, my TV, when it was new, it wasn't plugged into a surge protector, and at the time that we lost power, it messed up the power
supply. Well, always make sure your TV's plugged into a surge protector.
Oh,
let that be a lesson to you at home. Don't be like Lisa. Don't,
it wasn't on purpose.
Don't plug your television straight into the wall, because if you ever have a power surge, the thing could blow up. Now, Lisa learned the hard way. Now she plugs her television into a surge protector, into a power strip surge protector. Okay, so if there's anything you've learned by this useless video, you should always plug your appliances and electronics into a surge protector in case you have some kind of crazy-ass thunderstorm. What are you looking for?
I moved those so you wouldn't mess up.
I have to blow my nose in the worst way. Well, could you get me some tissue, please?
Sure. We can,
I've had to blow it the past 10 minutes, and I'm trying to get through this video, but I don't feel like leaving yet. I just feel like rambling. Excuse me, everybody.
He's about to blow up.
Whether it looks like it or not, I still do have a cold. Oh, did I mention my tooth is killing me? Oh, good.
He gave me the same cold. Isn't it nice for sharing?
What?
I said, I'm telling people you gave me your cold. I said, aren't you nice for sharing?
How do you know that you didn't give me your cold?
Because I didn't have a cold first.
She's always going to blame me.
No, you were sick first. I wasn't sick. And then all of a sudden I got sick from you because
I went outside the other day without a jacket on. That probably didn't help.
That's right. Oh my, I forgot all about that.
The thing is...
you just left like it was spring.
The thing is, I'm not in winter mode yet. I mean, for the fall, this has been a pretty mild... This has been a pretty mild fall around here, so I'm still not completely in the mode of winter yet. I haven't fully realized, okay, yeah, it's cold.
Peppermint bark.
But it isn't officially winter yet anyway. The official first day of winter isn't until December 21st, I think.
Okay.
So.
Have you ever had peppermint bark?
Peppermint bark? What the hell is peppermint bark?
I don't know. I see it here and I just wanted to know if you ever had that.
Tell me what it is first. No, I don't think I don't even know what it is, so how would I have had it?
I don't know. I'm asking you.
Peppermint bark. Has anybody heard of peppermint bark? I don't know what the fuck that is.
Barton's Gold peppermint bark. And this is raspberry and peppermint creams. They're little desserts, I think.
Let me see. I'm going to show everybody what peppermint bark is.
Can I
see, please? What?
From the bottom.
Have any of you had that? Can you even see it? The thing is with this camera, a lot of times I show things and there's a glare on it and you can't even see what I'm showing you. So you probably didn't see what this is. It's peppermint. Look it up.
That's why I asked you, it's a peppermint bark.
Need a new camera that I can actually see what's going on while it's filming. I haven't sent out Christmas cards yet.
Oh yeah, he's supposed
to. I haven't bought Christmas gifts yet.
What are you waiting for?
What am I waiting for? My tooth is such a nuisance right now. It's such a important issue going on with me that I can't concentrate on anything else. They always say distract yourself. Do something else. Take your mind off it. I have a very difficult time doing that with anything. And I don't tolerate pain well. So when I'm going through pain in any sort of way, no matter what it is, if I'm hurting, I have a very difficult time doing anything else besides just thinking about how much I hurt.
You know...
She's laughing.
I'm not laughing at you. This is the same thing with me. No, I'm laughing because it's so ironic because it's the same thing with me too. It's like... Take your mind off of it. Who's saying this?
It's like somebody repeatedly punching you in the stomach and telling you, it's okay, just don't think about it.
Yes.
How the fuck do you not think about something when that's all you could feel?
Like being punched.
And I also have no sympathy for people who don't understand that people could be going through pain and not look like that going through pain. Because I see a lot of people say, oh, you're in pain? Oh, you look perfectly healthy. You look perfectly fine.
Yeah.
Are you idiots aware that most of the time when people are going through a painful experience, whether it's emotional or physical, it doesn't show on their face, it doesn't show in their body. You can't physically see pain in somebody. Well, sometimes you can. I guess if they get hit by a bus, you can see them in pain when they're rolling around the ground.
Right.
But in most cases, in most types of illnesses or disorders, people are feeling pain. People aren't feeling well inside. People physically are not well, but they'll look fine. But you can't tell that anything's wrong with them.
No.
And these idiots who have it in their mind, unless you look physically pained, unless you look like there's physically something wrong with you, then I guess there's nothing wrong with you. People who think like that are fucking idiots. If somebody has the flu, you can't see that in somebody, so you don't know how they're feeling. How many times have you seen somebody out in public and you can just nail them and say, hey, they've got the flu. Look at them, they look like they have the flu. What the fuck does the flu look like?
I guess coughing.
Or if they're going through a bout of anxiety. They're going through a high stress situation. And they're feeling very nervous inside. Extremely, extremely nervous. How do you pinpoint somebody who's feeling like that? Oh, they look like they're very scared. You can't see. There's so many illnesses and disorders in the world you cannot see.
Unless they're running from a tiger going, I'm scared.
So I hope to God you're not one of those idiots who just dismiss how somebody's feeling just because they don't look like they're feeling sick.
According to them. Because there's no look of it.
Ignorant people do that.
Yeah.
My brother does that. Oh, you don't look sick. Oh, you don't look like you have anxiety. Oh, you look fine.
Hey,
fuckhead. You can't see anxiety. Show me what anxiety looks like in a book, you fucking mutant. Oh, look at these chairs.
It's random. You just look at these chairs.
This is a nice little card table.
Let me see. They'll bring it to
in the middle.
Oh, I see, with Santa on it.
If we had company over to play cards with, we could use something like that. Do you people play cards? I like Rummy 500, Gin Rummy. I learned how to play that stuff in Washington, D.C. with my cousins in a hotel room. Well, we had to place a chair in front of the door because we stayed at this hotel. It was in such a bad area. And we thought somebody might come in and kill us.
Crackheads?
There were all sorts of types outside. Didn't look like you could trust any of them. Please, let me just say this while I'm thinking about it. Don't do what my mother did. Don't plan a trip to Washington, D.C. and just think you're gonna be able to call a random hotel up when you get down there and then figure out where you're going to stay. See, that's bad planning. As a matter of fact, that's not planning at all. If you're going to go on vacation, always make sure you plan ahead of time and know where you're going to stay so that when you get there, you're not busy on a phone calling place after place hoping there's a vacancy. Because that's never a good idea. Take it from somebody who knows firsthand, that wasn't a good idea. I don't know what my mother was thinking. We'll take the Amtrak train down to Washington, D.C. Right. Where are we going to stay, Mom? We'll figure it out when we get there.
Oh, that's wrong. You shouldn't have did that.
Then we ended up staying in a shithole for a week.
That couldn't have been fun.
I don't know what she was thinking. I love my mom. God rest her soul. Rest in peace. God bless her. She wasn't thinking carefully that day at all.
Was she just winging it? Is that what that was?
She was winging it. You don't wing vacations. You don't wing your accommodations and where you're going to stay. It just wasn't a good idea. Whatever. I guess my parents, every once in a while, they like to just wing things. Not give it a lot of thought. That's never a good idea. It's fine to be spontaneous when spontaneity is called for. But when it comes to vacations and trips and things, you should at least plan a few things out, like where you're going to stay. You don't want to ever be surprised by bad accommodations when you're on vacation.
No.
The funny thing is, it was an awesome trip, though.
Well,
I get to see the Washington Monument. Went to see the U.S. Mint, where they make all the money. Went to Mount Vernon, Washington, where George Washington lived in a house. That's before there was a White House. He lived in Mount Vernon. Yep. Then we saw something to do with the FBI. It's some kind of tour of FBI headquarters. It showed us guns and things. This is a long time ago. This is 1979. October 1979. What were you doing in October 1979? I was sleeping in Washington, D.C. in a crack house hotel. This is the tallest speaker I've ever seen.
You don't know,
you haven't stepped near it. This might be skinny.
Why is my nose so itchy? I blew my nose, and now it won't stop itching. Maybe it's something to do with the material on this toilet tissue. Yes, I'm using toilet tissue to blow my nose because we don't have boxes of Kleenex here right now. Okay, just in case you're wondering why I'm using toilet tissue.
It's made out of the same stuff.
She says, it's made out of the same stuff.
Why are you mocking me?
No, I'm just being accurate in the way you described it.
It is the same.
I'm not mocking you.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to emulate your voice so people
That's
can...
That's mocking.
People can hear it people, exactly the way I heard it.
What do you mean they can hear its video? They don't need you to do it.
Just trying to be helpful.
No. They can hear me just fine.
Oh, my whole face is itchy now. You would think I do coke. Don't people do coke? Aren't they? Or crack or something? What drug is it where they're constantly itching their nose?
I don't think there is anything itching your
There
nose.
Is. There is. There's some kind of drug people take. If you know what it is, comment below.
It's
where
crack.
They're always itching, scratching their nose.
That's crack. And they're
it's crack?
And they scratch everywhere, not just their nose. They just sort of scratch their everything. And the same thing with meth. They just sort of scratch.
I swear to God, contrary to what you may think, I'm not on crack. I don't know where to buy crack. If I knew where to buy it, I wouldn't purchase it.
Yeah.
I can't even afford to get my tooth yanked out. How am I going to afford to buy fucking crack?
Crack is whack.
Crack is whack.
Crack is whack.
The most recent drug I've taken are these baby aspirin.
Low dose.
And I'm going to take another one right now.
Here you go.
They're tasty.
I didn't know they were flavored.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
They're orange flavored. I think they come in raspberry flavored.
Oh, make sure to remember that one. Why I don't know.
But do not over medicate, ever.
Nah.
It can be dangerous.
That's right.
But if I take a couple baby aspirin, I'll be okay. The only medication and only drug I take are legal drugs for anxiety.
Yeah.
And I barely take them because they don't seem to work well. So, I don't really like taking something if it doesn't work. It's unnecessary. I don't like taking unnecessary medication. Although, if you watch these videos, you would swear I'm hopped up on every kind of drug that exists. But no, this is the real me. This is my personality. I don't need drugs. I just appear like I'm on them. Hold on, I have to blow my nose with the toilet tissue again. Find something?
No, just these are the things I'll keep. This stuff can go in the trash.
What are you keeping?
These.
What's there? Something you're buying for Christmas?
It's possible. I don't want you to see.
Oh, let me see that.
No.
Let's see what Lisa's getting me. Come on, let me see. Come on.
No.
Let me see. Come on.
I said no.
Come on, I'm in pain. Cut me a break.
That's why I'm not showing you. Because it's for Christmas. It's a surprise.
We haven't put up any Christmas lights. We haven't put up any Christmas decorations yet.
No, because the animal will eat it.
Our cat Cooper likes to eat Christmas trees.
He's a lunatic.
So what we do is we try to avoid putting the Christmas tree up. And we try to avoid it as long as possible. One year I think we didn't put it up until the week of Christmas.
Yeah.
There was another year we put it up before December. It was right after Thanksgiving we would put the tree up.
That was a mistake.
And it was a big mistake because every day we had to deal with our cat chewing on the tree and eating it as much as possible.
And getting sick every time.
Oh my God, my nose is itchy. Did they say if your nose is itchy, somebody's talking about you? There must be a lot of people talking
no,
about me right
now. Your ears burning. That's what people are talking about you.
You know, I noticed that my nose itches every time I use this. Now I've made the link. There's a correlation between this and when my nose itches. I'm gonna have to get a new kind of tissue.
Well, have facial tissue.
Yeah, facial tissue would be nice. That would be normal to actually blow my nose with Kleenex and not toilet tissue.
Bleh!
Bleh! Bleh! Okay, that's it. Oh.
So this has been what? Jay-Z Crazy or Jay-Z Wazy?
This has been Jay-Z Lazy.
Jay-Z Lazy? I didn't say that. I said Wazy.
No, this has been Jay-Z Lazy. I've done nothing exciting this whole video. I've just sat and yapped about random shit that doesn't mean much to anybody. Not even myself.
Okay.
But you get this in place of a show tonight.
Listen.
Because I just felt like I wanted to sit here and talk to you people. That will occasionally happen. Why do you have your hand out? Do you want a high five or do you want
paper,
this?
So I wanted to read it. That is all.
Maybe I'll just sit here and scratch my nose for another 2 hours.
They don't need to see that.
Nope. Nobody needed to see any of this.
I mean, any further.
I'm still shocked people are tuning in. Do you know my numbers are actually up? I checked my YouTube analytics. View time is up. The amount of views every day is up. I mean, I have so many videos now that even if only each video gets a few views each day, it adds up to a lot.
Well, of course it does.
I have something like 250-60 videos up. You figure if each video only gets 4 or 5 views a day, if you add up all the videos, I'm getting 1,000 views a day.
Oh, look at Cage, you can get that from Molly.
In total. So thank you, people.
Yeah.
Appreciate you watching.
Yeah.
Just when I thought nobody was watching, I checked my analytics and people are watching.
Yeah. Yeah.
You just have to dig into the analytics a little bit to see. A lot of people out there, bored out of their minds watching this crap.
Well.
But thank you. I appreciate it. And I also learned that more people who aren't subscribed to this channel are watching me than the actual subscribers. Which makes no sense to me at all. Why are you subscribed if you're not watching? And if you aren't a subscriber...
Subscribe!
Why are you subscribing? I don't get it.
Subscribe so you can see.
So most of my viewers aren't subscribers. And my view counts are up.
Yep.
So I guess I shouldn't be bitching too much.
No.
Oh, I should be bitching about one thing. My tooth hurts. I'll be bitching about that for the next couple weeks. So as long as you're prepared for that, we're okay.
Right.
All right, I'm going to go now. Because to be honest with you, I've had enough of you people for one night.
They're not talking back to you.
Nope.
Oh.
They're not. Thank God. Thank God they're not talking back to me. I don't want to hear what they have to say right now.
That's not right.
It's probably not very nice. Comment. They can talk back to me in the comment section. I read the comments. I appreciate you people who do watch and comment. But they have a way to contact me. They can comment. They can do a number of things. They can hope that I die. I learned that last week. They can call me a pedophile. I learned that last week.
No, they didn't, because the person didn't even know how to spell it. They called you a pedophile.
Oh, that's right. I'm not a pedophile, according to this person. I'm a pedophile. And they came to that conclusion on the weirdest video. What video was that?
I don't know. Christmas?
I wasn't talking about girls, women, anything at all.
And that's not even a pedophile.
They just randomly called me a pedophile. They can't even spell for shit. Number one, they have an IQ of 2. Can't even spell the word right. Ah. But I thank them for watching.
Right. Even though they have no...
I told them to send the police.
Right. Nothing happened.
I said, I'm a pedophile. Uh-oh, that can't be good. You should call the police.
Yeah, apparently he's a obsessed guy with bread.
That's a pedophile.
Oh.
P-I-T-A.
Okay, I don't know what the hell they're calling you.
So you trolls out there, let me give you a piece of advice. If you're going to troll, at least have it make sense.
Spell.
I have a video online called YouTube Babysitter. Now, if that nut had commented on that one that I'm a pedophile, that would have made more sense, because that video was directed towards children because I was babysitting them via YouTube. Take a look at the video. It's there. Go to Jay-Z Crazy and look for YouTube Babysitter. Now, if that guy actually commented on that video, at least it would have made sense in some sort of weird way. At least you could kind of make a connection there. But he said I was a pedophile on some video where it didn't even make sense because I wasn't even talking about kids, children, women, anything.
Women can't be a pedophile for women because they're old enough. I don't even understand why someone would even do that.
I do. People are bored.
Oh, okay. You know what they should do when they're bored? Get a hobby.
If there was anyone who's less of a pedophile,
it'd be you.
Than me in the world, it would be me again. There couldn't be anyone who's less of a pedophile. Pedophile. Pedophile.
It sounds like you.
I bet you that was the brother of the guy who says he wishes I would die.
Or the cousin.
Or it might have been the same person.
Possible.
I don't know.
Maybe they have multiple accounts.
But if you people, if you have any sense that I'm breaking the law in some weird way, and you're confident about that, please, call the police on me. Why are you watching the video?
He hit me with a cereal.
There you go. I assaulted Lisa with a box of cereal.
No.
I accidentally hit her in the head.
By accident, on purpose. Because he did it twice. No, three times.
If you want to get me in trouble, then call the police about that shit. Don't make up crap about how I like kids.
Well, if the cops show up, I'll just say he's only a kid.
I'm never even around kids.
You know what? Even if you were, it doesn't count.
I don't have kids. I'm not around kids. And then on the few occasions I see kids, and I am around kids, I'm very nice to them.
That's right.
You know what I do? Go look at YouTube Babysitter, that video I did. That I do a bunch of that. Hi. And then they laugh, then I keep walking.
Right. Because
usually I find these kids in a store.
And they're with their parents.
They're with their mom, and they're sitting in a baby carriage or in a cart.
The mom laughs.
I go, hi, and the kid goes, ha!
That's it.
And that's it. Then I keep walking, and I continue my shopping. Oh, my nose is so itchy.
That's because it's itchy.
So I've learned this. When you're on YouTube, you're going to get a lot of people who call you random names.
And they won't make sense.
They'll accuse you of all kinds of shit that you've never done.
It won't make sense.
You have to be strong to be on YouTube.
Yeah.
I have a former friend. We put up a video a long time ago that he happened to be in.
Oh, yeah.
And people would insult him. And they'd leave nasty comments about him. What would they say exactly? You know better than I do. Come over here so people can hear you. What would they say about him? They weren't nice comments.
Who's the fat Mexican guy?
Yeah, my former friend I'm talking about. He looked like a fat Mexican, I guess.
And it says, oh, it's the nutty professor. Oh, wow, he got really fat.
Right.
And
he didn't like that.
No.
He saw these comments. And he freaked out to the point where...
Who is that, your fat dad?
He freaked out to the point where he said, take the video down, right?
Yeah.
Seriously, I'm asking you a question
real. Yeah, he did.
Or did he say just take the comment down?
No, he wanted the video taken down because everybody was talking about him. For like a good portion of the comments, it was all about him. Who's that fat guy? Is he your fat dad? Look at the fat Mexican guy.
A lot of my friends in life have been fat and overweight. I get along with everybody. That's I don't discriminate.
Nope.
I love fat people.
That's right, me too.
But apparently not everybody feels the same way. So when they get into your comment section, if they see any overweight people in your videos, they're going to be nasty.
It's rude. It's not appropriate to even fat shame somebody.
But anyway, this friend I'm talking about was an asshole.
He was.
Okay, being fat was the least of his problems. He would lie 24/7 about everything. But he's somebody who could not have his own YouTube show. Because he would not be able to deal with the comments. He would just have to shut off all the comments.
Yeah, he'd disable comments.
He wasn't a strong individual when it comes to getting feedback from people. He just couldn't deal with it. He's the type of person who couldn't have a YouTube show. Me, on the other hand, bring it on. Whatever. Because I already know 99% of what you're going to say to me is bullshit. People just like to be mean because they can. They hide behind a keyboard. Most trolls don't have a real picture up.
Nope.
Most trolls don't use their real names.
Nope.
They make multiple accounts so they can hide because they're pussies. If they weren't pussies, they'd be using their real names and pictures.
Yep.
So I'm certainly not put off and not threatened by people who can't even use their real names and pictures because they're pussies to begin with. So why would that affect me? It's like celebrities, even in the old days. I'm sure they got a lot of hate mail. The only difference between now and then is people send the hate via social networking.
Oh yeah, that's awful.
YouTube comments, Facebook comments. That's the way people like to be mean now. Back in my parents' day, or in my grandparents' day, people would just sit at the kitchen table and write the mean shit. And then send it off at the post office.
Yep.
But now, you don't even need to waste a stamp to send your mean comments along. You could just post them here.
Don't invite them, though.
Technology has made it much easier to be an asshole.
It is.
But I know it just means that you're not happy with your life. You're sad. You're depressed. You're angry. So you're going to send your mean comments. I understand why you're doing it. It's okay. It's fine. I hope things go better for you. I hope things in your life get to the point where you can actually be happy one day, where you don't feel a need to falsely criticize people or just be mean to people just because you can be. I know a lot of you are on power trips, and that makes you feel powerful. If you think you're making somebody else feel bad about themselves, that makes you feel powerful. I'll tell you right now, you're not powerful. You're a fucking asshole who likes to try to make people feel like shit. It's not gonna work with me. I don't care what kind of comment you leave. I don't care what you say. Leave as many nasty things as you want about me. As many false rumors. As many nasty comments as you can think of. Whatever. I realize you're just sick. You have a sick mind. And you're unhappy with your life. So you're going to be angry towards me. Or the next guy. So you're going to leave bad comments. Because you're going to act out like a little child. It's alright. I already know where you're coming from. I'm already in your head. I'm already a step ahead of you. I might not be a psychiatrist. Or a psychologist. But I have you figured out. And if you're going to leave mean comments towards me, I already know what's going on in your head. And all I can say to you is I'm sorry that your life sucks. My life is no bed of roses either. Okay? Okay. We all have our problems. We all have our issues. if you and I were to meet face to face and you're leaving me mean comments, you know, we'd probably be great friends in real life. But online, you want to be Rambo behind a keyboard. That's okay. You know what I do with that? I just read these comments. I laugh a little. Then I walk away from the computer. Then I think about how sad I feel for that person. And then it's over. I don't think about you any longer than 5-6 seconds. No matter how mean the comments are. And like I said, if you think I'm doing anything wrong, call the police. Why are you leaving comments for me? Tell the police what you think I'm doing that's wrong. Then they can deal with me. And then when they find out you're a liar, they could put you in jail for false reporting. Whatever you do, doesn't matter to me. My tooth still hurts. Ow. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. Lisa gets so bored of this whole thing, she left about 10 minutes ago. And my nose still itches. Ow. Okay, so I'll be seeing you back here sometime soon. Is it guaranteed to be tomorrow? It's never a guarantee. I started off doing this YouTube show. I put up occasional videos since April. I think there was 1 or 2 months I only put up a couple videos. Then in August, I decided to go in head first. I said, okay, I need to take this YouTube thing seriously. Since August 1st, I've done 2 shows a day. Every single day, 2 shows a day. This is now December. This is the 5th month. We're going into the 5th month right now, me doing 2 shows a day. And I'll tell you right now, I'm getting burnt out. But I also said I was getting burnt out 2 months ago, and I've still been here doing 2 shows a day. Yeah. Now it's like some sort of weird YouTube addiction. Like, I feel like I need to do 2 shows a day, but I don't know how much longer it's going to last. There may be a day that comes where I just want to do 1 video a day. Then I just may focus on quality a lot more than quantity. So when that happens, you may only get sporadic videos, but the ones you get will be kick-ass. They'll be really good. So there's a few different courses. There's a few different paths I can go down. I'm trying to figure this whole thing out right now. Remember, I'm crazy. So it may take me a while to get everything working the way it should. But the way I'm thinking right now is I'll finish December doing the 2 videos a day thing, like I've been doing. Then in January, there's going to be some sort of a change. I was planning on going outside, doing more prank videos, doing videos that are more likely to go viral. Because me sitting in front of this camera for an hour, boring you people with my life, this isn't going to go viral. I already know that. Videos like this aren't going to grow this channel. This is just me bitching about various things. I'm not picking up any subscribers by doing this shit. I know that. So, when the new year rolls in, probably focus more on some shocking videos, some types of things that I haven't been doing yet, and the channel will probably become a lot more fun. Yeah, that's what I'm looking at right now for the future of this channel. So stay subscribed. You don't have to look at all these videos. You don't have to look at every video I do. If the thumbnail catches your eye, or if the subject matter looks interesting, great, tune in. But if you don't, it's okay. Better stuff is coming. I have some issues to deal with the rest of this month, with my mouth, just feeling better. So I'm here when I'm here, and I'm not when I'm not. I'm not guaranteeing anybody 2 videos a day anymore. Even though it may happen, It's not guaranteed. So just consider yourselves lucky when I show up at all. Because I have to work out some shit. So the future of this channel can be ultra successful. Instead of Luke, medium, warm, eh. See, I've been here for a long time. My nose doesn't stop itching. I'm gonna bash myself in the head somewhere. So I'll focus on that pain instead of this. Where was I? Oh yes. My channel, okay, here's the graph. The graph is a box of Special K. Here's the very bottom. Doesn't really matter, does it? Okay, here. My channel is near the bottom right now. Now, when I say my channel is near the bottom, I'm talking about viewership, subscribers, how successful it is. Right here. I'm hoping that come January, some of these new videos I start posting, it can escalate my channel so it's up here a little bit more. Okay, this is me right here, near the bottom. This is PewDiePie. If you don't know who PewDiePie is, it's amazing that a person can be the most successful person on YouTube, have an income of millions and millions of dollars every year, just from YouTube. And a lot of people still don't know who the hell he is. That's amazing to me. You know, when you're a celebrity on TV, and you're at the top of your game, and you're making more money than anybody in your industry, generally, people know who the hell you are. It amuses me to no end that PewDiePie pulls in $4 million a year, or some incredible amount like that, and most people on the street don't know who the hell he is. There you go. You could be a YouTube celebrity and pull in millions of dollars a year, and people still don't know who the hell you are. They've never heard of you. But there's this guy called PewDiePie. Most of his videos were on gaming. He would talk over himself playing video games. And that's where he became popular and well known. Now he's expanded. He makes other kind of videos. But basically the guy is known for talking over playing video games. Somehow, through some kind of miracle, he became the number one most subscribed and most successful YouTuber ever. And and it gets me choked up thinking about it. And he stands there this very day. Right now, he's number one. He's at the top of the Special K box. I'm way down here. I'm being stepped on by a lot of people. So I'm just trying to escalate my little channel up. It's really hell. It's so hard to get subscribers. It's so hard to get viewers. It's taking me so much longer than I had planned to get subscribers on this channel. That's really unbelievable. But I'm not the type to give up. I will keep posting my insane ramblings day after day, month after month, until ultimately, I start to climb. I start to make the climb closer and closer to where PewDiePie is. And then one day, I hope to dethrone PewDiePie. As you were looking at Jay-Z Crazy, who will one day be the number one YouTuber in the land. Will that actually happen? No. Chances are I'm just delusional because I'm not feeling well. But we can all dream, can't we? Hi, I'm telling people about PewDiePie and how on a graph I'm down here being stepped on, by every other YouTuber in the world. This is where I am on the success scale right now. Very near the bottom. And I'm telling people that PewDiePie is here at the top.
Okay.
And one day I will dethrone PewDiePie.
Oh, have fun doing that.
If I don't die first.
If we can physically show up where he lives, just throw him off his chair?
No. I will not show up where PewDiePie is because my asshole viewers will look at that as me threatening PewDiePie.
Oh, yeah, you don't want to threaten.
And then they'll make up all kinds of shit. And tell, and tell PewDiePie that I'm after him.
You're not after him.
And God only knows what else they would make up. So there you go, everybody. So I'm trying to grow this channel little by little. And just stick with me, okay? Tell your friends. Send them a link to my channel. Tell them to subscribe. And watch the insane ramblings of a lunatic. And plus we play games and stuff. Usually it's not just me talking for an hour like this. We do fun stuff. Like I said, go back and look at all my videos, especially if you're a new viewer. Go to jzcrazy.com. Go there right after this video ends. Jzcrazy, all one word, jzcrazy.com. It'll bring up a whole list of all my videos. Start clicking on all of them. As a matter of fact, if you've got the time, watch all of them. Comment on all of them. Tell me which videos I've done that you like the best.
Even tell them the ones you hate.
Yeah, and the ones you hate. The ones you think totally suck. Tell me those too. Okay? Alright. So anyway, I'm going to go now. Thanks for tuning in to what must be my longest video I've ever done on YouTube. Right?
Yep.
How long have we been sitting here?
I don't know. I went to the bathroom and came back.
I can't believe I still have a voice. So as you can tell, my cold is going away. It's not lessening my tooth pain. But I think my cold's going away. Which is good.
Yeah.
Alright, so I'll see you to... No, not tonight.
Tomorrow?
I've already seen way too much of you tonight.
You can't see them.
I think I was going to say tomorrow.
Yeah.
I never like to guarantee people I'm going to see them tomorrow.
Well, they're not going to see them, they'll see you.
I might think of something better to do tomorrow with my time. You never know. I'll see everybody sometime soon. Alright? Okay. This has been Jay-Z Crazy!